Hi guys, welcome to the first video in this vlog series that I'm doing. Today I'm going to take you along with me as I clean and organize my music shelf. Now I have cleaned it and organized it a bit in the past, but it's been a few years and it clearly needs some help. So we're going to do that today, and hopefully this will inspire you to organize your own sheet music if you need some help with that. I have lots of piles of things going on in addition to this, and little scraps of paper where I have ideas written down because I don't have a good place to put them. So I'm hoping to remedy that today as well. But before we get started, I wanted to tell you all that my schedule is opening up a bit this summer, and I am looking for maybe 4 or 5 more Skype students to start harp lessons. So if you are interested in that, either if you're a beginner and you want to learn the basics of the harp, or if you are more of an intermediate player and you just want to learn more Celtic style, if you want some one-on-one help, perhaps with the tune tutor lessons that I've been doing, don't hesitate to give me an email. All of my links are in the description where you can get a hold of me, or just leave me a comment here on YouTube. So I'm going to show you what I did the last time I organized all this and some of the stuff that I still think are good ideas. And then we'll just let the camera play as I clean it all out. Okay, so here's one of my favorite things that I have done in the past that I will probably keep. I just might do 2 books instead of 1 because there's a lot in here and it's hard to stick up on your music stand and find what you're looking for. So I got this book at Joann Fabrics. It's so pretty. I love it. It's really big. It has lots of space. What I frequently do is I'll print off music from thesession.org, or I also have a lot of sheet music from Ohio Scottish Arts School. And what I did was take just these tabs and I organized it into, turn it this way so you can see it, I organized it into dance types. So I have marches, I have strathspeys, reels, jigs, I have waltzes and other type of tunes, and then I have airs, like slow airs and laments. It's all there. I have a Gaelic song with words, and I have just other songs that have English lyrics. So I like this system because I can, if I'm looking for, say I need a march for something, I can just pull out all my marches. But it does need to be a bit more organized, and like I said, there's just a lot of it. So that's something I want to fix. The other things I currently have are, I'm in an a cappella group as well as a choir, so I have my community choir music in my black folder, which I need. So obviously that's staying. And then I have some of the most current a cappella stuff in another black folder. So I use that too. I finally got a second black folder because I got tired of switching it. Plus, in here, I've got, this is a great book, by the way, Wendy Stewart, with a good CD that goes with it as well. You guys should check that out. I have my Carol Coppice arrangements. You guys should check those out, too. Any music I mention, I'll put a link in the description for you guys. Another one by Carol Coppice. Now in here I have vocal music, and what I want to do with this is take it out of these types of folders because I'd rather just have it in a binder so I can flip through it easily. A lot of it's from when I was taking voice lessons. A lot of Christmas music, and it's just not organized very well. It's all kind of stuffed in these folders, and I want to change that. So, Anyhow, by the way, guys, if you like Gaelic songs, seriously, get this book. It's so awesome. I'll put a link to it in the description. Of course, my collection of the Highland Vocal Airs, collected by Patrick MacDonald. This is a pretty cool book. I should actually, like, record some of these. I like this one, too. There are some things you keep around because you paid for them and you don't really know what to do with them. I will probably never sing this again. But, yeah.
Guys, piano music. I don't really play piano anymore. And yet, I'm keeping this. You know, I should probably give this to some of my new guitar friends. They might actually use it. Why do I still have my Italian textbook, you ask? So I had to show you guys, this is one of my mom's old music textbooks, I think from college. And I remember reading through some of this as a teenager, I think, and just finding it so interesting. So I'm keeping this one. Lüftchen.
Okay, here is what I got done in the past 2 days. Yes, it's taken a couple of afternoons and I'm still not quite done, but here is what I've changed. I put most of those vocal things in their own binder, so now that's all in there rather than in the floppy folders. My two folders are still there for vocal music. I still have, I think that's like more Christmas music in there. I might get another book for that. And then all my solo books. And in here I just put, so now I've got like some church music in here. So it's not all stuffed, so that's nice. And some Christmas carols in here that are appropriate for church, and then I still have to label them. Oh yes, I stuck my piano music in here. I don't know why I'm keeping it, but I am. And then I have, oh, this is something else that I do, by the way, and I really like it. I think it's going to work for me. Since I often don't take music with me to gigs because I stink at sight reading, what I do is I have printed out a 2-hour set list where I've timed it, and I know it's a solid 2 hours of music. So I just have written down, typed out what song, about how long it is, and then like how many times I play it through in order to make it that long. And so that way I can just take this with me and okay, this is what I'm playing next. And I also have a list of things that I can kind of just pull out of a hat to play. I have a list of Celtic stuff that's mostly ready or I can get ready easily. I have the list of sets that I sort of currently play. I have some harp and voice things that I could pull out of a hat if I needed to, or I could also ones I want to work on and get so they're ready. And then I've got a list of Christmas stuff that I could work on if I had a Christmas gig coming up. I also have ideas for hymns, some classical, and there we go. But I really like, it saved me a lot of grief having this 2-hour set list. So I used it at a tea recently, at a dinner, so I just have it there, and that's really nice. I don't have to sit there and time things. And now what I've done is taken this huge thing, pared it down a little bit to another book. So right now what I have in the big one is I still have my waltzes and dances, my airs, and my songs are in here. And then to this book I moved Oh, that's the wrong one. I was saying, to this book, I moved the marches, the strathspeys, the reels, and the jigs. So all those more peppy dance music is in this book. There we go. And this one, I also have more of the, I guess what you would think of as sort of wedding type music. A little more light classical. Let's see. Yuzu Joy. I have a Canon in D version in here. Minuet in G. And I also have some sacred songs in here, as well as my Christmas music, my Christmas harp stuff is in here. So that's that book. Okay, next to that, I just have my staff paper. I have my other harp books. And then I have my actual books. And what I plan on doing too is I need to get some more binders. Get one other binder and keep it just for the sole purpose of like putting ideas in, like YouTube video ideas, sets I want to put together, things like that. So that is my music shelf.
So thank you guys so much for coming along with me. I hope you enjoyed this little spring cleaning session. It's finally spring in Ohio, which means it stopped snowing. Finally. Be sure and click subscribe if you haven't done that already, and be sure and let me know if you are interested in some harp lessons. Also, let me know if you like this type of video. I have a few more ideas for more of the vlog type and advice type. Anyway, give this video a thumbs up if you are inspired to go clean out your music, and I will see you guys next Friday. Bye.